Welcome to my channel. In this video we continue with Spring Boot and Zolanda Logbook. This is part 2. We are back in Eclipse where we created a new project, Zolanda Logbook Config 1. First, you see the POM XML. I make it a little bigger. POM XML. Java 21, the logbook version 3.9.0, we have Spring Boot Starter Web and Logbook Spring Boot Starter. Also Spring Boot Starter Test, but in this case we don't use that. The main class is a standaard Spring Boot class. We have one controller, home controller, return string Zalando logbook, like the previous video. In this video we also created a new class logbook config. We have the logbook config. As you can see, most of the parts are commented out for the moment. Logbook config, annotation configuration, and we have one bean from type logbook. Here we create logbook builder and build it and return. For the moment, inside the builder we have nothing, only commented out things. A little bit later about that. First we do is run this application. Have started the application. Open Postman. Do a GET request to localhost 8080. Send it. And as you can see, we have the required body, Zolanda logbook. If we go to Eclipse, you see we had a totally different output from the logbook. The incoming request and the outgoing response with the body. We are back in Eclipse in the logbook config class, and we comment out the first built-in option. You see we have some error. We need to comment out the imports. Here the first one, second one, and the third one. As you can see, all the errors are gone and we can start the application again. Everything is running. We go to test localhost port 8080. We run it and we see we have again the Zalando logbook. As you can see, the logbook output is the same like in the first example. Does that mean this first option is the default one with the auto configuration from Spring Boot? Now we can test the second one. We comment out first, activate the second one. You see you have an error stream. We look at here, stream, comment out, the errors are gone. And we can run the application again. We go to the console. Everything is running. Open Postman. Send the request again to localhost 8080. Send it. And see, we have an output. The output is almost the same. Only the first one, this one, we don't have in the request and the response. Now we can test the third option. We are back in Eclipse. We comment out this one now. We need to comment out import for curl HTTP log formatter. See all the errors are gone. We can start it again. Put this a little up. Everything starts fine. Open Postman. Send the request. We have response body and the response from logbook Zalando. You see a totally different output. Go back to comment and comment out the fast JSON now. Fast JSON, this one. See no errors. Can start again. Top. Application started. Postman send the request. The request is okay. We have the response. And now we have a JSON output. With on the end the Zalando logbook. We go again to the code, and as you can see, we have many different options. Don't gonna test them all. You can try that for yourself. Only one thing to know: if you want to test this one here, you need to go to the POM XML and comment out this section. You see here logs test logbook. Logback and coder. These two you need. This was it for this video. As always, you can find the code on my GitHub account. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe and give a thumbs up. See you later and thank you very much.